All right, here we go. I'm going to tell you, I am absolutely blown away right now by the stupid things being said by people. We are actually convinced, some people are actually convinced that some of these just incredibly dumb things they're saying are right. Divisive and absolutely awful things that are not based at all on fact, but rather are based on a skewed and twisted misinformation that is being touted as being true and even right in some cases. Some of those things are obviously not fact, they're obviously not right, yet in order to push particular agendas, even certain news medias are promoting their one-sided lies as though there are absolutes and perfectly accurate. And if you go ahead and disagree with them, you are a closed-minded bigot who is the cause of the problems of this world in the first place, they tell you. And then you read social media and you see that there are some really loud and opinionated people who are also pushing similar agendas. And it is clearly and obviously just not true. But they're pushing it as though it is unbiased fact. Which if anyone did unbiased research, they would know that what's being said is not factual. And I'm really getting sick of all of that going on, and I'm sure a lot of you are too. And I wonder, how can people be so stupid to believe some of this stuff? Don't you wonder that sometimes? And then I'm reminded of something that happens in Daniel. There's really something that's going on in the background that causes people to say and buy into some really off things. Daniel ends up having a dream in the 10th chapter, and it has to do with things of the future. And the dream itself, Daniel didn't fully understand it, but he got some of it. And what he was able to grasp from it was so devastating and difficult on him that he spent the next three weeks after seeing this vision mourning and trying to get himself back to life as normal. And it seems that during this time, Daniel was asking God for a full explanation of what this vision he saw was all about. But he didn't get an answer from God on it. Not until after those 3 weeks had come to an end. And then an angel shows up to explain it all to him, and also to explain to him not only the interpretation of it, but why it took him so long to get there. Daniel chapter 10 verse 12 to 14 says this. Then he continued, the angel continued saying to him, "Don't be afraid, Daniel, since the first day that you set your mind to gain understanding and to humble yourself before your God, your words were heard, and I've come in response to them. But the prince of the Persian kingdom resisted me for 21 days. Then Michael, one of the chief princes, came to help me because I was detained there with the king of Persia. And now I have come to explain to you what's going to happen to your people in the future, for the vision concerns a time yet to come." So what does this have to do, you ask, with people saying dumb things? Well, the reason that people actually say these crazy, incredibly, obviously not true and dumb things is usually because they believe them. Now, that's probably even more upsetting to think about when those things are so radical and they're so absolutely destructive to a society that they will eventually lead to suffering or collapse. Especially when it leads to spiritual collapse in individuals. That's really what gets me. So why would people believe some of the crazy things that they believe? Well, what the angel and Daniel experienced was a spiritual battle that kept him from accomplishing what God wanted him to. You know what God wanted him to accomplish? Spreading the truth. You see, Satan is the father of lies. And if there is one thing he makes sure to spread, like a wildfire, it's lies. Ephesians 6, right? It reminds us that there's a spiritual battle out there that we really don't know a whole lot about, but it's warring against mankind to spread lies. So the next time you see someone who's convinced of something that you're looking at and you're going, duh, that should really be obvious. And then they're spreading those lies and they're believing them. I want you to remember something. They are just caught up in a real spiritual battle. And the best thing that could happen for them is not to think intelligent thoughts for a change. It's to have Jesus Christ infiltrate their hearts. And then he can infiltrate their minds. But there is a real battle going on behind the scenes between Satan and his promotion of evil and lies, and God and his promotion of good and truth and what is right. So the best approach that you and I can make is going to be a spiritual approach. I guess what I'm saying is this. Don't bother trying to debate or convince them that what they believe is just dumb until you have prayed for them and prayed for their soul and prayed that Christ would infiltrate their hearts. That's the difference maker. I think you know what I mean, and I hope that really makes a difference in how we approach things. We'll see you soon.